बच्चों गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट दिस पोएम द रोड नॉट टेकन रिटन बाय रॉबर्ट फ्रॉस्ट। रॉबर्ट फ्रॉस्ट इज अ फिलोसॉफिकल पोएट एंड हीज पोएम ऑलवेज गिव्स यू इंट्रोस्पेक्शन, ऑलवेज गिव्स यू अ सेकंड थॉट, सेकंड लेयर ऑफ मीनिंग। यू विल गेट अ डीप मीनिंग इन द पोएम, यू विल गेट इन द पोएम्स ऑफ रॉबर्ट फ्रॉस्ट। The name of the poem is The Road Not Taken. This well-known poem is about making choices and the choices that shape us and our life and the choices we make, the decision we take in our lives and the result of that decision, how our lives change either for good or bad. Robert Frost is an American poet who writes simply but insightfully. Yes, his poem you will find very simple, but you will find meaning in the poem about common ordinary experiences. So let's start the poem. Poem is very simple, but you will get the introspection, you will get the meaning in the poem. Now, the first stanza says, two roads diverge in a yellow wood. Two roads diverged. It means poet was going somewhere and suddenly there was a diversion of road, and suddenly the road separates into two. One road was going and then it separates into two. It means now the road has become in a fork shape. So now poet was going on a single road, suddenly the road divided into two roads. Now he had to take decision which road he should go, and in a yellow wood, and the time was yellow wood. Yellow wood, wood means forest, and yellow means forest generally remain green, but if forest is yellow, it means that it is autumn season. It means now the leaves are dry. Second meaning or the second layer of meaning in the poem is that always in your life, when autumn season means bad time will come, always you will have two choices before you, either do this or do that. So that two road always two choices will be before you in autumn season or in bad time. So the surface level meaning is that poet was going somewhere and suddenly before him there were two roads separates from one road in a yellow wood. Yellow wood means autumn season. Wood means now the leaves are yellow of that wood. And sorry, I could not travel both. In the second line poet says that he cannot travel both road. Yes, if he can travel only one road, he cannot take both road, so he has to select one. There are two roads before you, you have to select one. Which one is best, you don't know, but you have to take a chance, you have to take decision which one is better, you have to decide. And the result will come later when you will travel on that road. After that you will know whether it was a good decision or bad decision. And be one traveler. So he had to select one road and then he should become a traveler. Long I stood and looked down one as far as I could. So now he was at the juncture of the road, from at the point of the road from where these two roads are separating. So he was standing there and looked on the two roads as far as he could, to where it bent in the undergrowth. So he went, the road went into undergrowth. Undergrowth means it went in the forest area, in the shrub area or in the grassy area. It went into the grassy area, in the undergrowth. So it went, my road went into the shrub area. So first stanza says, again I am going to read it and you will understand it as I will read. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, okay, and sorry I could not travel both. and be one traveler, long I stood and looked down one as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. Now the second stanza, we will read second stanza. Then took the other just as fair, and having perhaps the better claim, because it was grassy and wanted wear, though as far that the passing there had worn them really about the same. Then took the other just as fair. Yet there were two roads, but other road, the second road, was very fair. Poet is saying that he chose the second road. Other option. Always in your life, when you are in problem, you will have two option before you. Either do this or do this. You will always have two choices before you in your difficult time. So here the poet is saying that he chose a fair one. Fair one means one road which was clean road, and having perhaps the better claim. And because this road was very clean, that's why this road had better claim. As no one had gone, it seems, because this was very clean road, so it seemed that no one had gone on that road. Because it was grassy and wanted wear. It was a grassy road. There was grass, so it was a grassy road. And because people were not going on that road, so that's why it was a grassy road. And it wanted wear, means it wanted that people should opt this road also. People are not going this road, that's why this road was a clean road. It was not a trodden road. People were not going on that road. Other road was trodden road. People were going on that road. So this road, this other road, need wear. Wear means it want that people must opt this road also. Though as far that the passing there had warned them really about the same. Yes. Though as far that the passing there had warned them really about the same. Although people are not going on that road, because they are thinking that this is not a proper road. People want to become a member of the crowd. They follow the crowd. They think where the people are going, they follow only that road where all the people are going. They never take a risk. They never select or opt or take decision on that road, on that path. They never go on that path which was not opted before. Now the third stanza. And both that morning equally lay in leaves, no step had trodden black. Oh, I kept the first for another day, yet knowing how way leads on to way, I doubted if I should ever come back. And both that morning equally lay. In the morning, both roads were equal. Both roads appeared equal. There was no difference between these two roads. In leaves, no step had trodden black. Yes, there were leaves in the other road, and no steps had trodden black. And there were no mark, no footprints, no mark of foot. It means that people had not taken this road. People had not opted this road. People have not gone on this road. Oh, I kept the first for another day. Yet knowing how way leads on to way. I kept the first for another day. So he took the second road and he kept the first road for another day. He thought that today I am taking the second road, other road, and when he will come, and suppose this this path, this road will be wrong, he will return and then he will take the first road. Yet knowing how way leads on to way, I doubted if I should ever come back. Although he doubted that he will never come back, he was not knowing which way he is going, what will happen, because he had no idea about the road. And this was the road where no people, no one had gone on that road. So that's why he was not knowing the result of the this road. He was not knowing where he will reach by going on that road. So that was the problem. Yet he was positive. He thought that he, if this step would prove wrong, then he will return again and go on that first road. Now the fourth stanza. I shall be telling this with a sigh, somewhere ages and ages hence. This thing is happening not for the first time. Poet is saying ages have passed. Ages have passed, centuries have passed. People are telling this thing that take different path, take that path where less people are going. So I am not telling this with a sigh. Two road diver in a wood and I took the one less traveled by. Always you will find in your life two road, two paths, two option. You have to select one. You always, there are two decisions before you. You have to select one decision. You have to take one decision. Two road diverge in a wood and I took the one less traveled by. And that has made all the difference. When you opted that road which is less traveled by, means about that road, about which people are not knowing. If you select that one which is not known by the people, it will make difference and people will know you for your decision, that you have taken a different decision and you are not part of the mob, you are not part of the crowd. Here in this poem you will also see that a poet tells about the difference between the city life and the village life, because if you know about the poet was very fond of village life. So here also two roads means one road which leads to city life and second road which leads to village life. And poet here wants to say that people must opt the second road, people must return to nature, people must come to the village life, people must prefer to village life. Now, so this poem were difficult words. Write this difficult word in your copy. Diverged means separated and took a different direction. Undergrowth means dense growth of plants and bushes, shrubs. Wanted bear means had not been used. Wanted bear means the road which wanted bear means this road which deserve that people should travel on that road. Deserve. So wanted bear means it want that people should go, people should travel on that road, hence means here. Now after that, where does the traveler find himself, what problem does he face? So traveler finds himself at a point where the road diverged, road separated into two. So he faced a problem, which road he should opt, which road he should go. Now the second question, discuss what these phrases mean to you. Yellow wood means dry wood. Wood means forest, a forest which has become dry. What is the meaning of it? It indicates season, it means autumn season. And second meaning is difficult time. Our autumn season is also symbol of difficult time. Second, it was grassy and wanted wear. Grassy means full of grasses, because people are not going there, that's why there were grasses. So it means it is not smooth. If you opt that road, that path which is not trodden by people, it means certainly you will face the problem, because you are the first who will go there. You will go on that road and make the path without your going. It means all the people who have gone first time, suppose the person who made a century first time. So first, when someone has done anything first time, that is always difficult. Then it becomes a trend and path. The first person who climbed Mount Everest, the first person, it was very difficult for first person, but later so many people followed. and the passing there, I mean, people who are passing there, leaves no step had trodden black. We have read in the poem, trodden black, leaves no step had trodden black, means there is no footsteps visible on that road. How way leads on to way. How way leads on to way. One road will give you hint of second road. The meaning is this, that your problem will give you solution. One way lead you to way. Now, question number three, is there any difference between the two roads as the poet described them? In stanza 2 and 3, in the last two lines of the poem, is there any difference between the two roads as the poet described them? Poet describes that there is any difference. So yes, poet says generally there is no difference. And only difference is that your decision make. In the last two lines it has been said. That makes a difference. What do you think the last two lines of the poem? Looking back, does the poet regret his choice? Are accepted. Poet accepts this choice. Poet says whether it will be good or bad decision, he is not going to regret it because this is his own decision. Have you ever had to make a difficult choice? Or do you think you will have difficult choices to make? How will you make the choice? Yes, in everybody's lives it happens that you have to take decision. Always you will have two decision before you, or two option before you. You have to select one, and whatever you select, you don't know whether it is going to prove good or bad, but your decision matters. You have to take decision, and generally you should take decision which other people are not taking. This will make a difference. After you have made a choice, do you always think what might have been, or do you accept the reality? After you have made a choice, do you always think about what might have been, or do you accept the reality? Yes, you should accept the reality. What will happen? It will happen. Be ready and be brave. Whatever will happen, it will happen. So do not always think that if you had opted that road, what will happen. Don't think about what would have happened if you had taken that road. No, you have opted this road, so think about this and always be positive, and whatever problem will come on your path, you have to tackle that path. This is the solution poet wanted to tell here. Jawaharlal Nehru has said, time is not measured by the passing of years, but by what one does, what one feels, and what one achieves. So this is today's poem, and this was a really wonderful poem, The Road Not Taken, by Robert Frost. Thank you very much. Thank you, class 1.